Today's video is brought to you by everyone's favorite game, Raid. It's not a backup. Before we get into my problems today, I'd like to take a second and thank today's actual video sponsor, Linode. A lot of my audience watches for the home lab and server content, but not everyone wants to dedicate an entire room in their house to a server rack, or wants the expenses of power, cooling, and hardware that come with owning your own servers. Linode makes it easy to deploy and manage your own cloud services, with solutions ranging from a single shared CPU to massive multi-core virtual machines. You can even add dedicated enterprise GPUs for machine learning. There's no project too big or too small. Linode isn't just for business or enterprise hosting either, with shared CPU plans starting at as little as $5 per month and scaling up to as high as you need to go, you'll be sure to find a plan that fits your needs. Linode also has 24/7 365 support available regardless of your plan size, which is a way better support plan than I have on my personal rack, I can tell you that much. Visit linode.com/craftcomputing and get a $100 60-day credit just for signing up for a new account, and get your home lab started today. That's linode.com/craftcomputing. And now, onto my nightmare. Welcome back to Craft Computing, everyone. As always, I'm Jeff. So, a little earlier today, I finished up shooting a video, uploaded all of my footage up to my server like I normally do, but then I decided to log into my TrueNAS server and just see how things were running. And I'm really glad that I did, because I guess early this morning, one of my RAID arrays went into a degraded state. A degraded state occurs when one or more hard drives decides to peace out, leaving your array in a slightly vulnerable state. Now, I run RAID Z2s on all of my arrays, which means I have a 2-disk tolerance, meaning that I can lose 2 disks and all of my data will remain intact. What occurred to me today, and I haven't fixed yet, is a slightly better than worst case scenario, because I lost 2 disks at the same time, meaning I have no more fault tolerance left in that RAID array. If I were to lose a 3rd hard drive right now, I would actually lose all of the storage in that pool. Lucky for me though, the datasets on that pool are not all that important. They are my Proxmox backups and my software repository of utilities, benchmark programs, and local installers that I like to keep on the server for fast installation onto other systems. And yes, the fact that I put my backup server together less than 2 weeks ago and started actually running backups on the regular makes me a very happy man because, well, RAID is not a backup. So let's go ahead and jump onto my TrueNAS server and you can see exactly what's going on. So right here is the pool in question. This is my Defiant storage pool, and as you can see, it is in a degraded state. If I go over to storage and then to pools, I can find out which disks are behaving poorly. And of course, it's the storage pool on the bottom, so I'm gonna move myself right up here for now. Down here at the bottom of the page with the big yellow triangle is my Defiant storage pool. Now if I go over here and click on the cog and then go to status, I can see which drives are actually failed. So it looks like disks 20 and 21 have faulted. Now, if you remember back to my backup server video, I was already having some problems with disk 21. Those errors did correct themselves, but it appears at this point, both of these disks are going to need to be replaced. Before we actually replace the failed disks, we need to set them as offline inside of TrueNAS. So I'm gonna select disk 20 right here, click the little 3 dots, and then go to offline. We're gonna confirm that and hit offline. Luckily, I keep spare drives for all of my RAID arrays on hand for just such an occasion. So let me go ahead and go grab those out of storage, and I'll meet you in the garage where we can get these drives swapped out. So luckily, with these 3 terabyte constellations, I always keep at least 4 of them on hand for, well, emergencies like this. These 3 terabyte drives are not the most reliable things, but they are about as cheap as you can get per terabyte. So we're gonna get these swapped out, and then I'll probably order a couple of more. Now, while the drives are hot swap, I'm gonna go ahead and take the server down and do a couple of upgrades that I've been putting off for a while. First off, I'm going to be replacing the cache disk with this Sun F80 module. This is an 800 gigabyte cache drive, and if you're interested in finding out more about this, don't worry, I have a video coming up on the channel later this week. And finally, I have a couple CPU replacements for the server. This is a pair of Xeon E5 2643 V2. Now, I have a pair of 2643 V1 CPUs in the server right now. This will actually jump me from 4 cores up to 8 cores, as well as an architectural jump from Sandy Bridge to Ivy Bridge. So, hopefully a little bit more efficient. Thank you. I don't know how much that server weighs officially, but I can tell you it's a heckin' lot. Anyway, the good news though is the server is back in the rack and booted up. So let's go ahead and reconfigure the RAID arrays inside of there and also get my new cache server up and running. Cache drive up and running, excuse me. Hopefully I didn't lose a third disk while we were doing all that. Data not available and pool is offline. I'm hoping I didn't lose a third disk in this whole process. That could be interesting. All right, let's go to storage, go to pools. Status. So I offline the disks before shutting the server down, and I've done procedures like that before, but I've been having a really weird issue, where when I boot the server back up, the entire Defiant RAID array states that it's offline, and none of the disks are actually assigned to that pool, even though there's still 6 out of the 8 disks that should be online. So here is how we're gonna do that. First off, I'm gonna go to storage, then to pools, and then I'm gonna click on the little cog right here under the Defiant RAID array. Then we're gonna go to status. So as you can see, drive 20 is still reading as offline. However, drive 21 has come back online, and I'm really not sure why that is, but we're gonna go ahead and replace these drives one by one. So since drive 20 is offline already, that's where we're gonna start. I'm gonna go out to the garage, swap that disk out for a good one, and then hit replace inside of the web interface. All right, I've now physically replaced drive 20. So I'm gonna go over here to the 3 little dots on drive 20 and click on replace. That'll bring up this menu right here. I'm gonna click on the drop-down menu and I'm gonna click on drive 20 and hit replace. And now we just need to wait for this process to finish and we can swap out disk 21. And we have successfully replaced the disk. So now I'm gonna do the same exact thing for disk 21. We're gonna click the 3 dots. I'm gonna set it to offline. We're gonna confirm. And now that I have drive 21 replaced, I'm gonna go ahead and click on those 3 dots again. We're gonna go down to replace and select the new disk 21. And hit replace. And yet again, we get to wait for this one to finish. And there we go. So go ahead and close that menu. And now that the Defiant is well on its way to being resilvered, should take about 7 hours, so hopefully by morning it is done. But right now it is time to get my cache disk added to my main storage pool. So I'm gonna go back to the pools tab. We're gonna click on the little cogwheel next to my 44 terabyte array and go down to add vdevs. Now this is going to be a cache disk, so I'm gonna click on the add vdev pull down and go down to cache. We're going to select our 800 gigabyte cache disk and then add that to the cache vdev. And if everything looks good, go ahead and click on add vdev. I'm gonna confirm and add. And there we go, that's all there is to it. Going back to my dashboard, you can see that we've upgraded from the 2643 V1 to the 2643 V2, complete with 24 threads, that's 12 cores and 24 threads, at 3.5 gigahertz on Ivy Bridge. And I think that's about all there is for today. I'm gonna let the system resilver, and hopefully in the morning I am back to a 100% healthy system. If you like this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to Craft Computing if you haven't done so already. Follow me on Twitter at Craft Computing to keep up with my daily shenanigans like this. And if you like the content you see on this channel and want to help support me in what I do, or potentially help buy me some new drives, then think about joining the Patreon or Floatplane. Links are down in the video description. As a bonus, you'll get exclusive access to my Discord server, where you can chat with myself and the other hosts from Talking Heads. Thank you all so much for watching this one, and as always, I will see you in the next video. Cheers, guys. I'm gonna go make a drink.